So I've been asked to remake this video, 30th of LSD. Here's what happened is, I was working at this coffee shop back like 10 years ago on Mill Avenue in Tempe. And at the end of the night, I would put all the pastries and shit outside next to the dumpster instead of throwing them in the dumpster so all the homeless kids could go and, you know, pick through them and shit. And I wasn't supposed to. You were supposed to throw them in the dumpster and lock the dumpster, but I said, fuck that. Because they were always gone in the morning by the time the boss got home or got to work, so. Anyway, I was walking down, going to catch the bus, and this hippie guy comes up to me, and I don't remember his name, but I'm familiar with his face. He's like, thanks, man, for the fucking food all the time, you know? And he was high as fuck. He's like, you want a fucking trip tonight, man? And I was like, I was off the next day or two, so I was like, sure, man. He's like, open your mouth. And stupidly, I did, and he had an eyedropper, and he squirted a bunch of fucking acid in my mouth. Like, I could feel it. And you're not supposed to. I could feel the shit running down the back of my throat. And I was like, dude, what the fuck? He's like, oh man, you're going to be high. That was like 20 or 30 hits of acid, man. And he was right, because I used to, well, back when I sold acid, you know, I used to use an eyedropper to put the drops on individual hits. And an eyedropper will hold about 20 to 30 hits. So I knew I was in trouble. So my goal was to get back to my house as soon as possible before the shit kicked in, right? Because I didn't know what to expect on that many hits. I'd never taken more than like 3 or 4 at a time. And 3 and 4, you're pretty hype. Well, I got on the fucking bus and it kicked in. You know, usually it takes like an hour to kick in and shit. Now this kicked in like 20 minutes. So I'm kind of fucked. And you know how like when you're on acid, like, you know, shit kind of breathes, you know, the colors are brighter, you know, you see tracers and shit. Not on 20 or 30 hits you don't. You lose your fucking mind, man. Like I almost went blind. I was hallucinating so hard. I was seeing just shit like melt before my eyes. I couldn't read. My whole frame of vision was like constantly like shifting like that. I was like, what the fuck? And I missed my bus stop because I was high as fuck. I got off at the wrong bus stop, and I was only like maybe a mile away from my house, right? But I was so high I couldn't even fucking walk straight, man. I ended up sitting next to the canal, talking to myself until the sun came up. And I peaked for like 5 or 6 hours, man. Not like 1 or 2 hours, like with a couple hits. I peaked like at least 5 or 6 hours. I lost all concept of reality and time. It was quite spiritual. And I wasn't really scared, though, because I knew it was just a drug. So I was more worried that I couldn't find my way home. And it took me like 8 hours, which should have taken me like 20 minutes. But I made it. I made it. And I was high for like 2 days. Kind of sucked. I started to get worried after a while because I was like, am I ever going to not be high again? So that was my experience. I don't recommend taking that much LSD. It's probably unhealthy. I don't think I've been right ever since. I got like this tick now.
I was hanging out with my friend Tetsu, and he suggested that I should probably do like a follow-up or commentary or something on the 30 hits of LSD video because it went viral again. And I was thinking about it. I really didn't want to redo the video because how am I going to retell the same story, right? I mean, I could give more details possibly, but that's about it. If I could just do a commentary, it was like, I don't know how many thousands of, you know, comments on the video. But I skim them once in a while and just like look for the fun ones. So I'm just going to kind of like respond or reply to some of the ones that I see popping up on a regular basis. By the way, if you actually want to talk to me or actually want me to reply about something, on my videos is not the best way because I really don't read the comments very often, once in a blue moon. But best way to get a hold of me is just if you wanted to ask me something or whatever, is just through my email, just, you know, how you get a hold of anybody else. I'll leave that in the video description below because, yeah, I've got 1,000 videos. So like in order for me to keep up on the comments, I would have to like literally like do it every day for like 20 minutes, and that ain't gonna happen. So, if you're wondering why I'm sitting in my car, I got some company over. I don't wanna keep them awake, so, and I'm smoking cigarettes, so whatever. One place left in the world I could still smoke. But let's see. I see the question a lot come up. Have you ever had a bad trip? I don't know. What do you think 30 hits of acid was? I wouldn't consider that a bad trip. I've had one bad trip once, and that was when I was in high school. Is the weirdest thing. This is why I don't mix drugs, at least with hallucinogens, is because what set it off, well, it was a combination of things. I did some mushrooms. I did some acid. They're on little sweet tarts. And I don't even know how many hits. We'll just say 2, 3. I don't know. And we did some mushrooms, maybe not a lot, think it was like maybe I probably did like a gram, maybe two at the most. But then we're fine. We're in San Diego and we're roller skating, skateboarding down the boardwalk. You know, having a good time, tripping. There's like three or four of us. Then someone busted out some weed and I smoked some weed, and that's what did it. When I smoked weed, I was like all of a sudden, like anxiety started coming over me. That's pretty much just what a bad trip is, right? It's just anxiety. But you know, when you're high, it's freak yourself out. I normally don't have anxiety attacks, but that was the only time. But what really set it off, I smoked some weed, and you guys are gonna crack up because there's any of you Star Trek fans. And I can't find this fucking episode. I almost think that I made it up in my head. If anybody likes Star Trek and, you know, knows the episodes, it's the Next Generation, by the way, knows the episodes by heart. There's this one, what set it off. It's the Enterprise, right? There's like an alien, of course, right? Attacks their ship, but it's in the form of like electricity. What set it off is it shows like, say, like Worf would go up to like, you know, whatever little fucking machine. And then it goes, and it starts shocking him, and then, you know, he like falls down, and the next person that touches him gets electrocuted, and he falls down. For some fucking reason, that just like tripped me out. Like I just like went, hey, it put me on a bad trip, and I ended up sticking in the mirror, and I'm like trying to pull my skin off, and I'm like looking at my face, and it looks all distorted, and like looking. It was kind of a bad trip. Yeah, that was the only one though. That was the only one. Never happened again. I don't know. And I've done a lot more acid, mixed drugs, but that, just something about that night, just too much. But, see, another question is, how many hits of acid have I done? I would have to guess, not including the 30 hits, because I don't really know if that was 30 hits or not. I don't know. I mean, you know, as a guesstimate. 20 hits, maybe 15, maybe 30. I don't know. Fucking too much, I'll tell you that. But all in all, without that experience, I would say, because the other times I could tell, right? Because I know how much I did. I would say probably somewhere between, I'd say around 150 to 200, right in that area. There was a couple year period where every week I probably dropped 3 to 5 hits a week. You know, now of course not all at once. You know, like I would like wait every 2 days. Because it takes your body like 2 days before. Otherwise, if you do it, you know, back to back, it doesn't work. You have to do like almost double. It's not worth it. But probably 150 to 200 hits. You know, and it's funny because another question, I'll just get to it now. Now on the topic, people were asking like, you hear that old wives' tale about, oh, if you take more than 7 hits, or you know, fill in the number, it could be 9, could be 10, whatever, then you're legally insane. You know, and fuck that. I mean, do I look insane? I'm not insane. If I was insane, it was before the LSD. You know, so it doesn't, you know, I with drugs in general, it's, that's an old wives' tale. That's bullshit. There's no evidence to support that. And besides, how could they even prove that? Like, you know, I mean, what, if that was provable, then that would be, you know, the ultimate defense for like, you know, a criminal defense attorney would be like, oh, my client, look, he did 30 hits of LSD, and now he fucking killed his whole family. He must be insane. Must be LSD's fault. No, it's not. People with weak constitutions who already have pre-existing problems, whether it's psychological or emotional or both, are going to be more susceptible to having sort of, you know, breakdowns or having bad consequences, which is why I tell people, you know, if you're suffering from depression and this and that, and other sorts of problems, probably shouldn't do drugs. I mean, that's kind of a recreational type thing. And if you have a not in the right mind state, it just makes it worse. I mean, I've dated some really fucking fucked up women that, you know, when, you know, you thought, you know, oh, fucking chill her out, you know, give her some of this stuff. Oh, no, no, no. People with a weak constitution, people with pre-existing problems, drugs are one of the last things you want to give them. So what's the other questions? I think that was the main ones. Yeah, bad trip. How much have I done? Yeah, I can't really think of any other ones. If you guys can think of some, I'll try to get back and read these comments, and maybe I'll add to the or make another video or something. But yeah, it's I don't know. You know, people. Oh, another one. People, do you ever regret doing drugs? How are you gonna answer that? Yes, I mean, sure I do. I mean, I don't regret it in the sense where it's like, oh, what happened if I would have never done drugs? My life would be so much better. You know, what, I could have been a fucking astronaut. Oh, you know, no. You know, I don't think like that. I mean, when I was younger, I did a little bit, but not that I'm older and I've looked at other people around me, people that I've grown up with that are my age. It's like, hey, this guy didn't do drugs and he's still a fucking loser. You know, it's like the drugs, again, it doesn't really come, the drugs don't harm people, you know. The people fuck themselves up. Some of them do it with drugs, but it's not the drugs' fault, you know. So you know, people are responsible for their own actions, and you know, people want to indulge in drugs and they have to be responsible for it. If they allow themselves to get fucked up and, you know, strung out or addicted or do stupid shit while they're under the influence, well, you know, then they probably shouldn't do drugs, you know. I'm not one to talk. I've made mistakes, you know. You know, I can make some more videos about that shit if you guys really want to hear my war stories, but. You know, I try to keep some shit to myself because some of it's kind of embarrassing. You know what I mean? I've done some stupid shit, you know, when I was fucked up on drugs that I regret. But you know what? I've done some stupid shit when I was sober too. So does it really make a difference? Probably not. Yeah, I don't beat myself up over it. I'm sure that, you know, I'd have more money. I don't even like to think about how much money I've spent on drugs. But you know, it's all been spread out over the course of, you know, fuck, almost 30 years now. You know, 25 years probably. So it's you know, I mean, it's not like you could just like snap your fingers and all that money go right into your bank account, because that would be fucking epic. But no, it's not gonna happen. So why beat myself up over it? Just like smoking, people are like, it's gonna kill you, right? Probably. But see, the thing is, I've been smoking now for fuck, almost 30 years. You know, 25, 26 years, something like that, and can I run a 7-minute mile anymore? Probably not. Now, if somebody was chasing me, I probably could. But no, but you know what? Even I, you know, I don't care. I don't care. I don't really run anymore. So I haven't had to run from anybody in a long time. So you know, you know, it's like drinking or doing drugs or smoking. It's like, yeah, okay, we know there's risks, right? Again, it's about being responsible. It's gonna kill you. Good. Am I going to die of lung cancer, emphysema, or some sort of smoking-related disease? Maybe, maybe not. You know, but the guy, I can ask the guy who doesn't smoke, you know. Okay, yeah, I might die of lung cancer, emphysema, right? What are you going to die of? Fucking colon cancer, heart attack, stroke, whatever, right? I mean, what is it? You know, fucking testicular cancer. What are you gonna die of? You know, it's like you're gonna die some way. I mean, and we would all love to think that we're gonna die in our sleep peacefully. Most of us, that's not gonna happen. Now, I'm not gonna, you know, waste my time and my life regretting, you know, the fun I had or the indulgences that I've had, because I may have shaved a few years off my life, or because maybe I, you know, die of lung cancer instead of fucking ass cancer. Whatever, okay. I mean, that's one thing that's inevitable is death. So I'm just gonna, you know, live my life for now, for the here and now, and you know, have fun while I'm here. You know, I'm not trying to promote living your life dangerously or recklessly, obviously, you know. But if you're an adult, I mean, you're responsible, and you know, you make your decisions based on what you know and what's information that's available to you. So that being said, yeah. So I guess that's really about it. I can't think. I forgot my fucking script. Not a script, but I forgot my little notes where I had the questions written down. And when I go back inside, she's gonna be mad if I come back out here. So I'm gonna finish up. But yeah, if you guys want to fucking shoot the shit, I'll drop some links in the description. Like, you know, I go to a chat room a lot. You see me plugging it from time to time. Just trying to get more people in there. You know, some cool people and stuff. Once in a while, you know, we try to do it, get together and stuff. I try to like set a time, but I can't fucking set a time. I don't. I work sporadic hours. You know, sometimes I don't work for a week, and then I don't have a day off for a month. It just depends. But yeah, if anybody wants to hit me up or has a question, just hit me up in my email. That's the best way to get a hold of me. I mean, you used to be back in the good old days of YouTube, you would like private message people and shit. I don't even fucking know if you can do that. If you can, I haven't checked any private messages on YouTube for years. So it's not that I'm ignoring anybody. I don't even know how to do it. Like, they've changed YouTube so many times that I just gave up on fucking. Fuck it, I'll just make videos. And hopefully YouTube won't kill me. So apologize about all the disclaimers. Obviously, that's something I have to do now. The last time I got lost my channel is because of my drug videos. So they're still out there, by the way. My channels are split now into two. Well, it's been split into two for a while. My main one was Satanic International, That was my main one. Then that got suspended. Then I created the Satanic Network, which is the one with 30 hits of LSD. Then I got Satanic International back. And so now I got two. So Satanic International and the Satanic Network are my two channels. I tried to keep the Satanic Network for just drugs. I tried to keep that one for like philosophical shit and Satanism and this and that. And they spilled over into each other. So it is what it is. But yeah, I've tried to make a playlist on both of my channels just specifically for drugs. So I know a lot of people, you know, don't give a fuck about, you know, whatever, philosophical, what my philosophy is or anything about that. And that's cool. You know, I don't care either. I mean, necessarily about yours, you know, but if that's all you want to see is the drug videos, then I have a playlist for those people who just want to see those. So you don't have to sift through 1,000 fucking videos. And if you ever wanted to download any of those shit, well, I think you guys have the apps and shit on YouTube. But yeah, I've got all my videos now backed up on Google Drive. So should I get suspended again? Or did, you know, terminate it again? Although I think YouTube gods like me at this point. If I get hit again, that'll be my fifth time. But yeah, I'll post the information and links in below. And thanks for watching. I'll try to make some more drug videos. I've got plenty of stories. I really don't party as much as I used to. I mean, don't get me wrong. Once in a while, you know, and once in a while I go on a little bender, but not like I did before. You know, now it's like, you know, so it's once in a blue moon type thing for me. I don't even really drink that much anymore. I still drink, just not like I used to. That's coming for a good video though. My next good video is gonna be how meth and amphetamine might have saved my life. That's a fucked up name for a video, isn't it? All right, bye.